Good morning, everybody. Thank you all for coming today. My name is Clint Saban. I'm the Senior Manager of Public Affairs at Medline, and I have one of the cooler jobs at the company, which is to travel the nation celebrating our great facilities and the great work that they do to make healthcare run better. And I'm really appreciating how much the community has supported us and welcomed us here in Mebane, and the RSVPs that we've had for this event is one of the largest of these ribbon cuttings that we've had this year. This is our seventh and final ribbon cutting of the year, and I'm just super appreciative of everybody's attendance at today's event. These types of facilities require the support of all of our government partners in order to be successful, and I'd like to take a moment to recognize those who have joined us today. Besides Mayor Hooks and County Vice Chair, who you'll hear from shortly, I also want to recognize City Council Member Jonathan White, Council Member Katie Burkholder, Council Member Sean Ewing, as well as Commissioner Amy Fowler, Commissioner Phyllis Port Ascott, and I believe Representative Price and Senator Meyer wanted to be here today, but had to go to the Capitol for business. So thank you all for coming today. I also want to give a special shout out to Table North Carolina, which is a local organization that provides healthy and nutritious food to 800 children across Orange County each week. And Medline is very proud to be able to partner and support that organization. And I believe Harmony Chavez is around here somewhere. Harmony, thank you for coming, Harmony. It's a great organization. We're very proud to support it. At the conclusion of today's remarks, we'll do the official ribbon cutting right where I'm standing, and I hope that everybody here will be able to join us in that photo opportunity. I may need to ask a little bit of patience because we'll have to get the podium and the chairs out of the way, and then there's always some logistics, and when the photo happens, we'll take our cues from the photographer to tell us when to smile. Afterward, we'll be providing tours of the facility. You should notice on your name tag a tour number, and that corresponds with what tour group you're in. You may be wondering why there's no tour group 5, and it's simply because the signs that we use to direct traffic, my group 5 sign broke over the weekend. But our tour guides are in the back. If you guys can wave your signs, that's what they look like, and I'll call out when those groups start. We do ask that when you are in the facility that you refrain from taking photos. Thank you. Now I'd like to introduce Medline's Vice President of Regional Operations, Paul.
Well, good morning, everybody. What a great day we have here. Couldn't ask for better fall weather. I know it might be a little chilly for some of you, but those of us that really enjoy the fall weather, we got a beautiful day to recognize this facility and do this dedication. And I just wanted to say that my role as VP of Operations kind of expands across the Southeast region. This is our second facility that we've opened here in the North Carolina area, and it really is a true dedication to the fact that we have the sales, we have the customers, we have the support of the community to be able to operate a beautiful facility like this. And like what you just heard from Clint is that you will, when you get a tour inside, you'll really be able to appreciate how much effort went into getting a facility like this up and running. And we do appreciate everybody that has supported us along that journey. Just to mention the fact that The ribbon cutting events, like Clint said, are, you know, we're paused for a little bit as we had to navigate through some difficult times and we were being very conscious about large gatherings and things like that. We've kind of caught up to that space and time now. A lot of us realize that probably during 2020 and 2021, we were building a lot of DC space because we wanted to be the supplier that our customers could count on. And we wanted to have that resiliency that when things happen in the world, we're there for our customers and we're able to provide the service, the products, and the value that we have with our MedTrans fleet to be able to get products to our customers when they need them. And it's an important aspect of what we're celebrating today, because this is one of those true flagship type of facilities in the Southeast. This is one of the largest medical grade facilities that we do have in the Southeast. And I think you all will appreciate, once you see the automation, the technology, and all the effort and engineering that went into it. I do want everybody to understand that Medline as a company here more recently, because of the investment that we're making, is we're trying to make sure that we have concentration in the space so that we are there for our customers. 70% of the U.S. News and World Report healthcare companies do business with Medline, and that's a significant increase in the number, in the volume, in the percentage of which we are operating with in that customer space and base. We also are the continuum of care for our customers, right? Whether it's a nursing home, a patient home direct, any of our government sales, any of our prime vendor hospital networks, we are there for them in all of those spaces so we can provide the services and the products that they need. And that's something that we're very proud of as we've built up this region. We now have 9 distribution centers in the Southeast region, and about four, and I'd say about 4 or 5 of them are fairly new and have this state-of-the-art type of automation so that we can continue to service our customers with a high quality of product and delivery. So I did want to mention that as we've moved our vision into supply chain execution, Medline has really kind of focused on the areas of safety, service, quality, cost, and people. I won't go into the definition of all those 5 areas, but it helps us concentrate on being a supplier of choice, because we will focus on quality. We will focus on service. We will make sure that our people are taken care of and make sure that they're safe when they're operating in these facilities. And because of that, that's a differentiator for us in the market, and that's why it's a true commitment to all of you as customers that we feel very honored to have your business. And the last thing I just wanted to say was, while we have the opportunity to share and celebrate the opening of a facility like this, I think it's also important to understand the hard work behind the scenes that goes on with our sales teams, with our customers, and with our local DC operation folks to make that happen on a day-to-day basis. It's always nice to have the splash and have the newness of things, but after you accomplish that, sustaining it at a very high level is extremely important to us. And that's why we have those 5 areas of work, so that we always take care of our customer. We always make sure that we're looking at our own team members and making sure that the things that we're doing is that we're operating safe and that we're taking care of them as well. And lastly, when we look at Medline as a whole, we want everybody to understand that our vision is not only are we great for our customers, but we're great for the environment, we're great for the community, we're participating back and making sure that we're giving. And when you talk to team members about living in this area and working for Medline, I think the one thing that all of them will tell you is the positive experience of that is what's going to overflow into the community as positive influence there as well. We give back to the community, we participate in community activities, and we're also a very good environmental partner so that we make sure that we take care of our waste and things like that. So very proud of the operation and the things that we're doing here. And I just wanted to say thank you to all of you for coming here and celebrating this with us. Thank you.
Thanks, Paul. You know, I've been working in public affairs for 20 years, and I honestly couldn't count the number of mayors I have met in that time. And I was really happy last night to have the opportunity to get to know your mayor a little bit over dinner. And I don't think I've ever seen or experienced a mayor who's quite as thoughtful and purposeful and caring as our next guest speaker. And I can definitely understand why the community continues to bring him back to City Hall every year. please join me in welcoming Mayor Hooks.
I was beginning to wonder who he was talking about. And I actually was the only mayor there last night, so maybe it was this. You know, it is indeed a tremendous honor to be here today. What a great day to be in Mebane, Orange County, North Carolina, and USA. It has just been a tremendous 2 or 3 years seeing this facility grow and come to fruition. And today is a very exciting day for Mebane and the partnership that we're going to have with Orange County and with Medline. So it is indeed a pleasure to be here. Mebane is a community with a strong past foundation. Citizens that are working hard to further build upon the foundations of the present and has a future that will remain positively charming. I want to welcome and thank you so much for today's ceremony, as this event represents another example of making sure Mebane's future remains positively charming. I love that phrase. When we adopted it, I was thinking it was named after me, but it was quickly pointed out it was about Mebane and not a thing. Before I go, we've already introduced our city council, which we have a tremendous city council, and there is a dynamic group to work with. But I do want to introduce our city officials. We have Chris Rollins, our city manager. And we have Preston Mitchell, our assistant city manager. While I know trademark infringement is probably a gray area, we make health care run better. And when I introduce these two gentlemen, we make government run better. And I am pleased to be associated with them in all the 34 years of my service on City Council. On behalf of the Mebane City Council and city officials, we are excited to be here today with Medline. Mebane is very well known for its growth and its location, but our high quality of life is what really makes those first two items relevant. Mebane and Orange County officials and community leaders recognized that our community was going to have to partner and make investments in the future, in the infrastructure, to remain economically viable and attractive for industries in the future. It began in earnest 20 years ago. This resulted in our partnership in creating the Buckhorn Economic Development Zone. I mentioned the partnership of a public sector, but this facility and today's event represents the partnership achieving the goal of a private-public partnership, with Medline selecting Buckhorn Economic Development Zone for their 1.2 million square foot facility. There's an irony in the timeline of Medline selection and then construction of this facility. They began construction during the COVID-19 pandemic and the construction of a facility to distribute essential medical supplies to help save lives during a pandemic and afterwards. Medline is a valuable partner for our society in Mebane, North Carolina, and is known, and I quote, "more than a medical supplier, we make healthcare run better." What a great quote. Medline, we thank you for what you do and for choosing Mebane and Orange County, one of your newest facilities, to positively, charmingly distribute from. In conclusion, I would like to mention and compliment both and present Mebane and Orange County officials and community leaders to encourage our partnership and economic growth. This area is set and ripe for tremendous economic growth, and we're excited about it as long as our partnership continues to exist. We shall see success. Again, thank you to Medline for becoming the new industry and community partner with Mebane. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. That was positively charming. Chair Bedford wanted to be here today and speak. Unfortunately, she's not feeling very well. So I'm so appreciative that Vice Chair McKee could join us. The relationship that we have with Orange County is very important. So please welcome Vice Chair McKee.
Good morning, everyone. I'm sure that everyone who has lived in or visited or spent any time in North Carolina appreciates the fact that this weather that we've got today is a bit unusual and is welcome relief from the summer heat and humidity. As mentioned, I'm Earl McKee. I'm a vice chair of Orange County Board of Commissioners, and it's my honor that to be here to represent our board and Orange County residents in welcoming Medline Industries to our community. Before I get started, I'd like to mention that Commissioner Phyllis Porte Escott is here with us today also. As was mentioned, Chair Bedford feels a little bit under the weather. She had her COVID shot, and I'm not sure exactly how well it's working out for her, but I understand she's doing a lot better than having COVID, and she's feeling a lot better today. Our other commissioners, Commissioner Amy Fowler, Commissioner Fowler, great, I didn't see you earlier, thank you. I have a very hard time, for whatever reason, I get in a crowd, and I can look right straight at somebody looking for people, and I'll look right past them and not even see them, so my apologies, Amy. But Commissioner Fowler is with us also, Commissioner Sally Green, Commissioner Gene Hamilton, Commissioner Honor Richards send their regrets. They had prior engagements or work-related responsibilities. Assistant Manager Travis Mirren is here with us. And I'm not sure, Travis, is Bonnie with us? County Manager Bonnie Hammersley also has responsibilities this morning, was unable to be here. 4 years ago, and that sounds like a long time, but for us, it's a short, fairly short interval. Economic Development Director Steve Brantley, who is with us today also. Mr. Brantley deserved a great round of applause because he has brought more economic development to Orange County in his tenure than any other economic development in my that I know of. So he is an instrumental part of bringing this in because he brought this project to the Board of Commissioners 4 years ago. And then working with him and working with our partners at the State Department of Commerce, the Governor's Office, and particularly the City of Mebane, who has turned out to be a wonderful partner in these ventures, we put together an incentive package that invited Medline to choose Orange County as the home for their new facility. They did. And we are glad, very glad, that they did. Increasing in number and diversity of well-paying jobs available to our residents is a priority of our board. And we're excited about the kinds of opportunities that this facility will provide now and in the future. Currently, more than 250 good-paying jobs will ultimately be located here, and it's my understanding that that number may continue to rise as we move forward, with the prospects, as I mentioned, of many more in the future. These jobs will support families who will send their children to our schools, frequent our restaurants and shops, and become part of our community. The Medline employees will be working for a company recently named by Forbes as one of America's best large employers and one of America's best employers for women. And this in itself speaks volumes about the culture and the climate of this company. At 1.2 million square feet, this is the largest commercial building in the entirety of Orange County. It has an assessed property value, my understanding, of approximately $98 million. And that will have a direct impact on the diversity of the tax base in Orange County and help relieve pressure on our residential property owners. This location will bring a boost to our local economies for years by attracting other companies to Orange County, but its benefits will extend well beyond the boundaries of Orange County into the neighboring region. And while we celebrate the jobs and impact that will be felt by the county and the region, this facility will also improve health care services delivery throughout North Carolina and throughout neighboring states. Then by helping providers activate the clinical and supply chain resources needed, desperately needed, to deliver their best care. Improving health outcomes is a goal for the Orange County Board of Commissioners, and we can't wait to see the positive impacts that this facility will have on our neighborhood and our community and our region. So, in conclusion, I thank Medline for choosing Orange County, and thank you and to our representatives from the state, from Medline, and all other partners for making this a reality today. And on a personal note, and on behalf of our board and the residents of Orange County and the surrounding region, welcome to our community.
Thank you, Vice Chair McKee. We are happy to be here. I didn't realize we were the largest commercial building in the county. That's kind of cool. Please join me in welcoming our Vice President of Sales, Ryan Glinka.
Good morning. I feel as though I'd be remiss if I didn't mention the weather and the perfect football weather that we have here today. Everyone else has, so why not? Thank you, Mr. Mayor, Mr. Vice Chair, and thank you all for being with us here today. This facility is a part of Medline's strategy to make healthcare run better in North Carolina and across the country. At Medline, we help healthcare providers activate the clinical and supply chain resources needed to deliver their best care, and we look forward to expanding those capabilities right here in Medline. Medline has continued to invest in the resiliency of the supply chain, and this $1.2 million square foot distribution facility is one of the latest expansions as a part of our $2 billion healthcare resilience initiative in new distribution centers and manufacturing, as well as upgrading technology. All of this is so that we can deliver superior customer service throughout the continuum of care. This investment also includes investing in fuel-efficient MedTrans trucks, one of which we're proud to display for you here today. These trucks are essential to delivering to all those healthcare providers. Before I want to also reiterate that Medline believes that we are a crucial part of the nation's healthcare system. Our commitment to our customers is that we're here to make healthcare run better so that they can remain focusing on serving the patients. To this point, Medline has over 300 people employed just in the Tar Heel State. Our closest partners have created the opportunity to serve the community directly and allow us the opportunity to serve our existing verticals like hospitals, surgery centers, reference labs, nursing homes, and doctor's offices, as well as venture into new ones like animal health, contract research, and EMS. In conclusion, we've talked a lot today about what it takes to make a facility like this successful, and working with our customers and our public and private sector partners, like our local partners here have mentioned, are a major part of that. But none of that matters if we can't have a strong and dedicated workforce here locally. So for all the folks in the back, how about a round of applause for serving the community? And as you go on today's tour, I hope that you'll take the opportunity in joining me in thanking them, because they are really the ones that make healthcare run better. Again, thank you very much for everybody for being here, for the dedication, for the commitment to us as a company, and more good things in the future. Thank you.
Now I'd like to introduce the man who runs this facility and has the honor of cutting the ribbon here in just a few moments, our Director of Operations, Joe Pete.
you. Thank you, everyone, for joining us today. It's truly an honor to be a partner with all of you. Besides being an investment in Medline and our customers, this is also an investment in the community. I'm proud to say that we've kept the promises we made to you. I'm also thankful that we've had so many community leaders join us today to celebrate the opening and to tour the facility and continue our engagement with the Medline Mebane community. A facility like this makes healthcare run better throughout North Carolina, and it could not happen without our local support. I'd like to thank the mayor and vice chair for your being here and participating to help us to support the life-saving work that we do. To our friends and neighbors, we are committed to keeping the promises we made. Medline will continue to be a good neighbor. Medline will also continue to support the local programs and projects within the community. And we are also committed to being an economic development partner for years to come for the entire region. I'm especially happy to see the representatives from Table, North Carolina. They've delivered healthy food and nutrition education to Orange County children since 2008. We're also thrilled to support their operations as they deliver food to 800 kids across Orange County. The biggest thing is our dedicated team that you can see part of our shifts are behind you is the biggest asset to Medline. I'm proud to work alongside with them. We have a great team. You see most of our morning staff. We also have a tremendous team in the afternoon together across the full day. They work to make healthcare run better to get the product out. I'd like to recognize all of them, but it would just take us probably over a week to get through all 260 of them. But I will take a chance to recognize a few special people today and during this celebration here. And when I announce you, could you please come up? Corey Cox. He's way in the back, so he's coming. Yeah. Phil Cody. I don't think he's here yet. Is he here? 2:00, yeah. So Ryan McPeak, he's one of our evening persons, so we'll make sure he gets his reward then. Janice Penix Bowden. She's somewhere. There she is. Myra Sosa. Fred Ponder. Yeah, I'm on. In addition, we talk about Medline being a career facility. It's been a great company. I've had 29 years with Medline. It's a company that's really great for being able to start at the very bottom and work your way up. And that's kind of the way my career went with Medline. And today, I want to announce that Fred has worked his way up. We have offered him a position as a supervisor, and he has accepted it.
Thank you, Joe. It is truly our team that makes healthcare run better. So we can just give our team one more round of applause. Before the tours start, we are going to do the photo. And again, I hope everybody here will join us in that photo. It is a little bit awkward because I got to get the podium and the chairs out of the way. And then we'll take our cue from the photographer on when to smile and say cheese. So if you guys can help me with that, I'd appreciate that. And after the photo, I'll be calling tour groups. So thank you. Oh, jeez.
Did you all?
If we can please have our...